Good morning, thank you for coming. My name is Diego Ruete, I come from Uruguay. I'm a teacher, I'm a cook, and for the last 10 years I fooducate. Fooducation, what is fooducation? Fooducation is to obtain the most benefits of planting and cooking with children. I do it with children from 3 years old and above. Those were 4-year-old kids and they were cutting. Many people teach how to learn computing or languages or some other skills, but what's the point if we don't take care of ourselves? Everything starts by respecting the soil, yes? Teaching them how to respect the soil and how to get the most out of it. We teach them to plant. We teach them how to take care of a plant, how it grows, and how to cook it afterwards. With a last benefit, that it's health, a healthy living, okay? In the meanwhile, we are working lots of things and we are getting the most out of it. We're learning values, we're learning attitudes, we're learning knowledge, scientific knowledges like mathematics, biology, chemistry, tolerance, patience, respect to the soil, respect to our bodies, respect to the others. For education is, I think, is necessity and a basic fact that we must take care in every educational institution. The three bigger impacts that education has is the healthy living, of course, the benefits that it brings to the family, okay? The kid that fooducates will take this home and will try to grow his own plants at home, yes? And he will try to cook with his parents. As a father, I know the benefits it has. And I know that loads of generations have lost that contact with soil, and lots of people doesn't know where the food comes from. A few weeks ago, a woman told me the only plant I saw growing was the pea at school when I was a child. And that was very sad for me. She was like 50 or 60 years old. And the community relations, and you will find out why. That's me in my vegetable garden with a school working. We are planting carrots there. I find in carrots the best vegetable to grow with them. On every vegetable garden I have carrots, because the impact of getting out a carrot of the soil is much better than the one to see a tomato ripe or a chard grow bigger. The carrot is quite significant for them. It's a very graphic. When we go to the market, fortunately, I have a street market at every Wednesday at my street in front of my house. Kids that come to visit me, schools do visit me, and to cook, and the ones that who schedule Wednesdays are booked all year long are booked, because they know they have the street market, and we go there and we listen to the noises, to the sounds of the street market. We see the colors, we smell, and we are socializing too with the people in the street market. Then we take it home and we cook. This is a community vegetable urban garden we started a year ago. A woman came and told me, "Oh, Diego, you like planting. I have this house. It's 300 meters backyard that it's turning into a jungle." it's turning out it was a jungle. Why can't we do anything with that? And yes, we did. A year has passed, and now we are a group of 5,500 people working in several community gardens in Montevideo, in Uruguay. People that are coming from grandfathers, foreigners, children, we all share the same concept, the care for nature. And we noticed that that will was a sleeping, it was a necessity that was latent. I don't know if that word exists, in fact. And it still grows, it's still growing. It grows that much that we work with prisoners in jail. They get in contact with us. They ask for seeds. And they build their own vegetable garden in prison. And now they don't have any more room for plant. And they, our seeds, they give them back to us as little plants that we take to schools. And they feel good doing that. They are returning something to society, and they are being part of it. There are only 10 or 15 prisoners working on the vegetable garden in a jail that has 1,500 prisoners. And once they told us, it was with the carrots again, the man in charge told us that once prisoners got into the vegetable garden, other prisoners, and cut all the green parts of the carrots to eat them because they were starving, and they didn't know that the carrot was inside the soil. They just took the green stuff and they left the carrot. And that's why, because they don't know, and we don't know, people doesn't know nothing about plants. We are letting others feed us, okay? And I believe that we can grow even an aromatic herb at home. And if we have kids, it's much better for them. See, that's what I tell you about carrots. He just took a carrot from the soil. It was a baby carrot. It was not ready, but look at that face. It's amazing. Motor skills. Yes, he's cooking with a knife. And the girl next to him, she's 3 years old. And she already finished cutting. And they ask me, are you going to use knives? Yes, and we use garden tools. And we use mixers. And we use blenders. And we do use knives. They learn how to use them. They develop motor skills. They develop loads of abilities, and they get a better knife or a dangerous knife showing responsibility. If I can trust them, they will get a better knife, and that helps their self-esteem, and we're working on that too. This is a school where I work. On every Friday, I go over to their place and we prepare lunch with them. It's a school, these children go in the afternoon. So in the morning at 10, we get all together and we prepare lunch. There are kids from 3, 4, and 5 years old. On every Friday, we cook our own lunch from scratch. We're making the dessert here, I guess. I don't remember. So I quote Michael Pollan's phrase, and let you read it. And to finish, I will tell you that next step for us is to form teachers into Fooducation so they can use the vegetable garden and the cooking classes as a tool to obtain better results and ending in a healthy living, in a hands-on activities, okay? If they do, they learn. if we tell them, they will forget. But if they are with hands-on activities, we believe the result is much more better. Thank you.